Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Building with B-double-O. I'm going to sound a little funny today. I'm going to cough. I'm going to snort like a pig. It's going to be a mess, but that's okay, right? We're getting some videos out. So, last episode, I got some fun stuff for today. Let me just tell you that right off the bat. But last episode, we finished off this area, and while we did that, it wasn't super content heavy. You know, we did some cool stuff in here that I'm happy with, but more than anything, we kind of talked about balance. Me trying to get some balance in my life. And I'll tell you what, I made that vow to you guys that I was going to try that. And it is working out pretty good. First thing, I fly like an eagle. First thing that I started to do, here's a little insight into the life of B-dubs, okay? It's not glamorous all the time. First thing that I did comes with a little bit of a story. So, my daughter Eden was born in May of last year, and May of 2016, dating the video, but since then, I have not slept upstairs in the same bed as my wife in probably... I've probably slept up there maybe 20 times in the last 9 months. Yeah, not good. And the main reason why I was doing that is because I was working. I was working super late, and I don't like how this looks. I was working super late, and in that time, I do like that. That's better. In that time, I would come to bed at like 4 or 5 o'clock, and Nicole's sleep was low because the baby kept waking up, and I didn't want to wake her up at 4 or 5 o'clock because she was just getting a couple of hours. So out of courtesy, I was just sleeping downstairs in the basement on the couch. Not good. Luckily, I have a very fantastic wife, and it didn't really hurt our marriage. But it definitely doesn't help. And I mean, as stupid as it sounds, it's a big deal. So I have been going to bed at a normal hour, at a normal time. I haven't been staying up super late. I've been waking up earlier, and that has really helped, I think. I knew there was something going on down here. I knew it. What is this? What did I do? There's stuff down here, man. Beto's a terrible person, I know, but it was out of the kindness of my heart, and yeah, there's something down here, man. I knew there was. But anyway, I think that's really improved. And Nicole and I have gotten, it's just better. It's improved things for us, certainly. And so that's one of the big improvements that I've made. The thing is, I'm waking up a lot earlier. I'm waking up at like 5:30 in the morning. Hello. Saddle, hello. I'm waking up at like 5:30 in the morning, but that means getting pretty tired and falling asleep around 10:30, 11. So that's good. I mean, that's really good, but a little bit it hurts some things. Like all the crew guys start playing at 10, and that's like when I'm like dead tired now. So that sucks, and I need to kind of work out like some days that I can do that, but anyway, balance wise, I'm sticking to my promise, and I think it's really helping because my video production, it's been a lot easier to make videos. I'm not waking up and thinking, man, I got to hurry up and get a video out, rush it out as soon as possible. I can get up at 5 o'clock and I got plenty of time. Okay, so I'm supposed to be able to stand here and get a bunch of mobs, right? Didn't I make a... Yeah, there's a bed down here. I made a mob grinder down here, didn't I? I think I sure did. But anyway, just to let you guys know, yes, finding that balance is beneficial. So we talked about that last episode. It's a good thing. Try to do it yourself. Balance your life out. Live a normal life. Don't go too hard on one thing. And good things can happen. I want to find where this mob grinder is. Maybe I just shut it down, huh? I may have just shut the whole thing down. Here's this. You know what? I did. I did shut it all down because it was all above ground. It was all above ground. There's a chest here. The cow is right here. Okay. Interesting indeed. Let's just leave that all clogged up, shall we? Let's try to get up right here. I just wanted to see if I still had like a working mob grinder down here. Because, you know, the one thing that I really love, the one block that I really love, probably the most, hello, is the bone meal block. That thing is awesome, but I don't have a lot of bones. I don't have a lot of bones, and the only way I can get them is by going out at night and killing skeletons, which with a looting sword, I can get them pretty quickly. But anyway, this is coming down. This is coming down. I love you, man. I love you building. You are great. But you're going away. And let's hop up here and see if there's any resources. Oh. 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 Okay. So there's a lot. Yeah, this is coming down. This is great real estate. This is a great spot right here. And something that I'm going to do to really improve this area, because you guys have said in the last episode, you happy that we're working out here again, and you want to see some stuff done and see the area improved. Actually, yeah, that's what I want to do. It's over there. But I do want to do a little bit out right in this area too. A lot of different opinions on what to do, what to try. A lot of people said just hold off on the castle right now, kind of work on the area, work on the lore and the style some more before you really dive into the castle. So I'm going to do that. A lot of people said work on like a town hall, and this is a big bit of real estate here that could work for that, but I'm not really feeling that. At the moment in this location, I don't think it'd be great. So I'm going to try some other things. I've got some other ideas, but I'll get to work on this demolished job and I'll be back with you shortly, shorty. That is a nice plot of land right there, isn't it? Oh man, you know what? I told myself, I can't believe that just came out of my mouth. I told myself years ago, I'll never call something a plot. I will call it a lot of land. A lot. That's what you purchase when you buy some land and you want to build a house on it. It's a lot. I'm calling it a plot. A little plot. There's a plot of land. It sounds so gross. Blech. Plot. That's a nice little lot of land. Okay, there we go. It's nice. I think it's good. We just got to get that cow out of here. But here's what I want to try here. And I'm curious, how out of place is it going to be if I put some medieval, obviously medieval, because that's kind of the theme that we have going out here, the feeling, some medieval type row houses. Row houses are kind of like, let's see, dark oak. Yeah, that's okay. What do I have a lot of? Just dirt, really. Might be the best thing. I got a lot of cobble. Maybe we'll go with that. Row houses are tall and thin for the most part. They're much taller than they are thin. Most houses that you think of, normal style houses, are usually wider than they are tall. A row house is a tall house. There are other characteristics that define a row house, but I think that's the easiest one. I feel like that could be good. Part of what's hurting this area is the emptiness. It feels rather empty at times, and the more we kind of fill it out, the better it's gonna get, in my opinion. That's what I'm thinking. Let's get this, because this clay is very beneficial and useful. And we fill it in. Let's fill it in, because we love it. We love it, our area. We want it to look nice. Boom. So, yeah. Oh, man, that's so cool. I do enjoy that. So, row houses here with possibly a street going down the middle, but not like this. And I'm almost not thrilled with how these streets are. They're almost too perfect, but it is our main area, so maybe it's cool. Let's just kind of get like a little bit of an idea structure-wise. Right up to it, let's give it a two-block difference on both sides, okay? They're definitely deep. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do we count in odd numbers now? Is that what we do in this game? Maybe. And then we'd go, just give it a 1 on the backside. So then we put these here. Ah, there's a hole down there. Boom. And I can set you right on top of you. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That would give a little bit of distance on this side. They don't have to be perfect, you know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. 5? Yes? 5? 5 by 8? I'm gonna try to work in odd numbers more because it feels like that's the direction the game is headed. But this is odd numbers now there. If we went this direction, I just makes me feel like we should go, it should be a deeper house, but this could work definitely on the smaller scale, and maybe we need to make it bigger, possibly. But let me get kind of a little bit of a layout. The main thing I want to do, I want to, of course, figure out the sizes, but height. I want to just get some grids in for height so I can just sense it, because these are very low, but I feel like it would be a good transition to over here. The arena is very tall, so it would kind of transition us up to that. Give us some good elevation changes. But we'll see. We'll see. Let me kind of lay some stuff out and see how we looking. Nothing in the game pains me more than this. This is the hardest thing for me to do. Because these trees are so beautiful. And they add so much to this lovely game. And I have to tear it down. I have to tear it down. Pave paradise. Put up a parking lot. I don't want to, but I have to. It's part of life, I suppose. The natural flow. But this tree gonna come down to make way for good things. Hey, it's dark out. Can I sleep up here, please? Please, 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 please. The bed's down there. Oh, geezer. Ha! Ooh, delicious food. Sleep! Okay, so I've kind of got a little bit of a layout going here, and I think it's looking pretty good. I'm fairly happy with it. I think it's going to be nice. I am running out of this axe, though. It's getting low. All right, how much more wood could there be in this tree? What a gorgeous beauty it was. And I see you up there, hiding out, doppelganger. That's not what a doppelganger is, but it felt like a good insult. That's one of my favorite things to do in life, is just make up words that work out to be like, wow, that doesn't really mean anything, but boy, my feelings are hurt. That really hurt me. You'll be surprised at what you could come up with. Okay, make a jump. We did it. I think that's a good clear out job. I think, yeah, that was bad. So, Let's take a look-see once we get this clear, and as all this despawns and I collect the saplings and whatnot, because we tear down a tree, we plant three. That's how it works. Let's take a look at what we got. So I didn't do like a perfect layout, but I did do a layout nonetheless that's going to hopefully give us enough of a feeling to where we are going to see how this is going to be. So definitely coming this way, right? We're going to get an idea. And I don't want to go massive huge, right? A regular row house, if I was to do it, I would probably go a little bit taller than this. Maybe 3 or 4 blocks taller. Get it up about here. But we're working with a certain scale. And I think that this would work with this scale. Have some buildings that are about this height. And, you know, kind of trying to mess it up a little bit. And you'll see what I mean. I don't want it all perfect. I don't want them all to be the exact same depth. I'll even change the height. This is just for reference. But these are facing this way, obviously. Different depths there. But then here, we're going to be facing this way. And what that's going to create for us, and I'm willing to make this sacrifice, and I think we can make it work, is coming this way, we have a big long wall. This will be the front of this building right here. And let's go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then boom, 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 like a so. Very good. And boom, boom. And back down to here. Okay. Like so and like so. Hey-ya. There we got it. So that'll be this house. That'll be the front side or the front face. And all of these houses on this side will go like that. The reason why I'm doing it like that is because this is the main entrance from the south. What direction am I facing? You tell me. I can't see it. South. Yes, from the south. So if you're coming from the south, southern lands, Timberstone and the like, Escher and all those, you'll be coming through these gates, and this is what you see. You got a nice view of the church right there, which I'm glad this kind of allows for that. But then there's not really much to see over here. This arena is a work in progress, certainly not gorgeous by any means. So we'll probably end up covering some of that. Now I'm okay with that. So I think having these facing towards this entrance will look good. It'll give just like a nice row house look right here, and it'll make the place look very nice and populated. So I'm happy with that. We do have to find a new home for you, Mr. Cow, providing us with delicious milk all the time. That was basically my thought process with the layout, and I think I'm happy with it. I think I'm cool with it. But now we got to really start working on getting. We got so many apples. I suppose we start eating some, huh? The snack of choice for B-dubs right now. Let's build one. This is all kind of using our imagination to get an idea of how it's going to look. Now let's build one. And, you know, it's going to be similar to some of the designs you've seen from me in the past. But I think it'll fit in very nicely here. Guys, was just looking for some bone meal. Found a little bit. 64. But look at this. Remember this? Does anybody remember this? If you were here for this, give yourself a little shout out. I mean, it's a pretty cool idea. I mean, we've got all that land up there, but we dug out this huge area down here, a huge dig out job. And we made space for a jungle tree farm, a spruce tree farm, a birch tree farm, and an oak tree farm as well. I mean, oh, and our slime farm is over there. I can hear it. But this is great. I think what I will do, just off camera, is I'm going to replace this with a dark oak. This will be a dark oak tree farm. But this is so good, man. Whenever I need wood, I forget that this is here, but it's glorious. It's such a good way to... didn't need those. Such a good way to just collect a bunch of wood. It's just all right here. And really, this is, I built this with the old mechanics. I could really put these a lot closer together now. But yeah, no luck on the other bone meal, but this will work. This will do the job, I think. So I've been doing, I got to talk to you guys about this. I've been doing some talking with some friends, and I think we've got some exciting, fun stuff coming up in the future, video-wise. Just keep your eyes peeled, okay? But speaking of keeping your eyes peeled, hey! Oh, I placed those manually, didn't I? Sure did. Yep, because I made a drooping tree. Shut up, phone. Phone was ringing. So anyway, here's kind of our look. I'm kind of doing things a little bit differently, but I think it's getting there. Here's the front of the house. Looks good, right? Looks nice. I like it. We're going to do some things like we're going to put a little flower box there. And boom. Excuse me. Thank you, sir. Okay, gonna have to jump for every one of these, looks like. Hello? That's fine, that'll work. Little flower box there for our enjoyment. But I think the roof looks nice. I spent quite some time trying to figure out what are we gonna do with the roof, and I took a look around, and we've got a lot of oak tree. We've got a lot of oak wood roofs there. And in some other places, I fell down as well. So I figured let's stick with the theme, okay? And let's do that. And we can make it still look very nice. It's a nice differentiation from the actual building. It definitely separates itself from the roof, and I think it looks good. Lining it with cobble as well, which you don't really see, but I think that adds some nice structural interest to it. Now you're seeing this side and you're thinking, boy, this is kind of boring, B-dubs. Looks a little bit on the boring side, and you right. You so right, baby. So we're going to spice it up a little bit, okay? First of all, you know, the way this base connects to the ground is nice and boring. So we want to mess with that at some point, but I don't want to get right into that right off the bat. I want to kind of work on the rest of this thing to kind of get an idea of what we can do to improve it. And if we go here, I do have a bunch of bone blocks in this bad boy, so that's nice. I'm thinking, okay, let's have a little jut out right here. How big? Well, let me tell you this, first of all, because we're going on these odd numbers or even numbers, I wanted to put like a post in the center, but I couldn't do it. Had to put it off to the side. And you know what? It kind of still looks cool, kind of still does the job. So I'm learning, working in the even numbers can be a good thing. Can I reach? No, I cannot. Let's do a climb job. Okay, there we go. And let's go here, 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 and even down one more. I like it. I like it very much. Let's go with even numbers again. We're having fun with even numbers. Why not continue, shall we? Yeah. Boom. Yes. Come back to daddy. Yes. Good boy. All right. I'll never be able to say good boy to one of my children because I'll never have a boy. Because I can't produce males. I can only produce females, apparently. That's what the rumor has, anyway. okay, so, ouch. But that's fine. Like, this is a thing, right? We're building this out, and it's looking pretty cool. But it's a little bit boring now. So, let's try to do some stuff here. Let's try to kind of make it look good. Okay, grab this. Thank you very much. And let's get up here. And of course, we'll tie this in a little bit better. Down all the way? I don't know. Maybe not. We'll see. Maybe not. Just for interest's sake, maybe not down all the way, but like three, like that? I think we do have to come down all the way. And we're gonna go to sleep real quick. so the mobs don't kill B-dubs. Don't to kill me, screwjob bobs. Don't to kill me. My nose is feeling better. I'm feeling, I bring that up as I just called mobs bobs. Oh, cool bob. Cool bob trap. Idiot, stupid. Okay. Boom. Boom. Yes. Think. Think, think, think. Just like poo. Think, think, think. All right. And boom. Boom. Okay. Thinking. Boom, 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 boom. Kind of. It's a little bit of interest, right? We put a roof on it? I think we put a roof on that and then we make it look nice, don't you think? I am feeling a little bit weird about this. Was I right originally? Was I correct in thinking that we should do this? Boom. Boom. Maybe. You know what? The fact that these things come way down like this, I don't love it. Oh yeah, I'm gonna need these. Waste not, want not, right? Boom, boom. I'll take you back, thank you. What do we put here? Another log? Yes, I like that look. Excuse me, sir. May I borrow this? Thank you. All right, let's put one here, and I think that's gonna make it look nice. You know, this is my process as I go through. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. That's nice. It looks cute. It's good. Sorry, I said cute like that. Let's get... I'm out of stairs. Let's get some stairs going. You know what, actually? Maybe it's wood. Maybe we do wood stairs. Let's go up there and give it a shot. Okay, so we're gonna go... We're gonna go right... Here? I don't want to get too crazy with it. Like this? And then... Okay, let's just see. Let's see what how we do here, okay? Boom. 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 And those will tie into here. Okay? So that'll tie in there. That'll tie in there. And here. And we can get these back. Yeah. Come back to daddy, please. Thank you. And then we'll come straight across here. Straight across here. And then I forgot what we did on the other side, but I believe it was something like this. Right? Yes, and that was an upside down piece, so we'll just come in like so, like that. Tie in. Okay? That's cool. Let's just get a look at it and see how it looks. Oh yeah, that's nice. Isn't that nice? That really adds a whole bit of whole lot of depth to this, and just makes the side look more interesting, you know. And we're gonna have to find ways to do that because these sides are very important. We're gonna have some very large sides here, and we're missing a piece there, and we're missing a piece there. Now, these are very important pieces because when you have these row houses, you'll have long edges like this, and they've got to be interesting. They can't be boring, especially if they're exposed. So another cool feature that we're going to have in this house is that, I'm not sure. Oh, I can kind of see what we did over there. We went like, get that out of there. And we went like this. Yeah. I think that's what we did. Row houses usually share walls. You go inside one and you usually see like brick on the interior walls. And that is because it's sharing a brick exterior wall with the other side. It's pretty crazy. But it's a cool look. It's something that's pretty popular these days. Hello? Am I unable to jump? Very fine. It's not even, but that's okay. I like this. Are there just so many skeletons in here? I hear them just rattling around like madmen. Did I move the door? Oh yeah, that used to be a door. Okay. Yeah, that looks glorious. And then what we can do from here is we can do some other little fancy things, okay? So we come in here like a dis, and we knock this out, right? And we pop that out, and we get some... Oh, I'm out of these too, I think. I'm not even going to take the time to really look. I'm just going to make them. Boom. There you go, buddy. And we pop that guy there, and we pop this guy here. Little window right there for your likings, and we do the same on the other side over here. But already I'm not feeling as weird about this base because we've got a nice interesting lower part or upper part, I'm sorry, and then a two wide window here. Let's give it a shot. Let's see how it looks. We could go too tall as well. And maybe that would be the best thing. But maybe that's good just as is. Whoops. Place that. Okay. Boom. And boom, boom. Good. Yeah, that's going to need a little bit of work to make it a little better. But, boy, I think that looks nice. Huh? It's pretty cool. And then just pop some windows in here and I'll pop them out from the inside. Thank you for the materials, because we want to keep everything on the same level. So let's get a window like here. Hello? Not there. let's go here. That's good. And maybe here as well. And that'll kind of help us determine where our kitchen and other walls will be, I think. Boy, we really could have benefited from having a window here, actually. Maybe they'll both be there. Who knows? We'll figure that out in due time. But I think this looks good overall. I'm very happy with this look. And we're going with red windows here. And I think it's a. I think it's going to work out for us. Do we make these two? No, I like that height. I think that height is very good. But now we talked about the base and making the base look good. Something I did here is I made like a little basement window. This is just a couple of upside down stairs with some stuff underneath, and we can do that. We can do that, but we can also do stuff like this. We can go boom, 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 and it just adds to the that's not so great. Excuse me, sir. Just adds to the structural look of things. It makes it look like it's a little more I don't know if solid's the word, but just it just adds some more detail. Notice as we stand back, it still gives the same feel and the same idea, but it looks like an actual structural building now, which I like quite a bit. Yeah, this is a good start. And I think this is what we're going to do for the rest of these. They're not all going to be like this. They're all going to kind of be a little bit different in their own way. You can come down a little bit. You could be up. I like that. Maybe even a closed one. Nah, let's leave them open. Let the light shine in. I like that. And then we come in with some bone meal and just bone meal this grass up on the outside just a wee bit. Don't want to waste too much. There we go. And maybe you get two. Right? Hiya! No. That's good, just like that. Very good. Okay, and that just makes it very nice and interesting, doesn't it? These we could do, like, if this is going to be an open space, we could do a lot of tall ones back here just to kind of make that look a little unkempt. But I think that's good. Overall, pretty good look. It's not perfect, but I think it's good. We'll get some street lights in here and the whole place is going to be glorious indeed. All right, so I think this area has got a good start. This is now something to do off camera because you guys get the idea from here. But it'll be a lot easier from here because this, I only have to do the front. This one, I'll have to do the side, but some of these middle buildings are going to be a cakewalk. So it shouldn't be too bad. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you got some inspiration. Hopefully you're excited for the next episode because it's going to be a good one. Love you guys to death, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Yeah, you see this right up here? This is a what they call a choke point in the middle.